One of the most common SETI-related comments I get is that the WOW signal is case closed, having been explained as natural radio emissions from a comet. This is actually a misconception, due to the widespread press attention the initial story received. However, what the press didn't cover as much was the aftermath and subsequent developments in that story, which put the comet explanation in doubt. Perhaps this shouldn't be surprising. The WOW signal has proven itself over the last four decades to be particularly resilient when faced with natural explanations for it. There have been quite a few advanced over the years, and all of them have fallen short. In this case of the comets, it was based on a paper by Antonio Paris and Evan Davies, and a subsequent paper by Paris, links below, where it is suggested that either of the two comets are strong candidates for explanations of the signal. It was pointed out that the WOW signal's frequency was near 1420 MHz. This particular frequency is called the hydrogen line because it's where hydrogen, the most common element in the universe, can emit radio waves. The thinking is that anyone in the universe working with radio would know that, making it a natural frequency to use to make contact with other scientifically minded species. The authors note that two comets were in the area when the WOW signal was detected, and the clouds of hydrogen that surround them could have been responsible for emitting the signal. While at first glance that seems reasonable, but the paper ended up setting off a debate, and the devil ended up in the details. In the end, the WOW signal emerged unexplained. The reason for this new chapter in the decades of debate and controversy is because the WOW signal wasn't just an odd signal, it was exactly what we would expect to see in an alien signal. For one, it was a very loud signal on the order of 30 times stronger than the background. That's a problem for the comet explanation. It's not that comets can't produce a signal at this frequency, that's an open possibility, it's that it's not likely they could do it with this much energy without getting noticed long before now. Another complication is that the WOW signal was also extremely narrow in bandwidth. Natural radio sources generally tend not to emit narrowband signals, but technology does. It's almost a hallmark. But the real problem with the comet hypothesis is that the WOW signal didn't repeat. That's right, the one thing that hurts the WOW signal most as far as candidate alien signals go, in this case also discounts a natural explanation. If it were a comet, the radio telescope should have picked up the signal again within minutes. It didn't. Whatever the WOW signal was, it was there 1 minute and gone the next. Comet clouds are diffuse and huge and simply wouldn't have abruptly cut off their transmission. In short, the comet hypothesis falls flat. But all explanations for this signal likewise fall flat. Interference from Earth is not probable. We've internationally agreed not to broadcast on the hydrogen line just in case of alien signals coming in. A glitch in the equipment isn't very likely either. The telescope never showed any such glitch again, and the smooth bell curve nature of the signal rising and falling is consistent with the telescope passing over a legitimate radio source. Unfortunately, unless this signal is picked up again, and it hasn't been even though plenty have looked, that's all we're ever going to know. Another thing I often get asked about this signal was whether there was any information content in it. Despite dubious claims otherwise on the internet, there was not. The circled letters for the signal, the famous 6EQUJ5, are only a measure of signal strength. The columns are kept to one digit, so all other numbers are different radio sources. 1 and 2 are the most common and represent weak background signals. 3 to 9 are increasingly stronger, and you can see the strongest signals were also circled as interesting. Higher than 9 signals moved from numbers to the alphabet. That the signal got to U in the alphabet is amazing. It shows how strong this signal really was. But otherwise, it appeared to be an unmodulated beam of raw radio energy broadcasted narrowband at the hydrogen line. Think of that like a flashlight. If you have a friend standing 20 feet away sweeping a flashlight beam past your eyes, you would see the light rise and fall, but there wouldn't be any information in the light beam. In this case, it was the radio telescope scanning past, and the source was a point, which would be expected from a planet or star system with a transmitter in it. But no content wouldn't be too surprising for an alien civilization sending out a signal to get the attention of other species. They would know that it would be unlikely for that alien species to decode any kind of signal, so raw pulses might be the more likely first contact message, though all it says is, here we are, but maybe that's all you need to say. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently wondering what would happen if the first transmission we intercept from an alien civilization is someone's angry response to the WoW signal aliens telling them to quit being so cryptic. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.